Right, the National Party Convention. So, following the primary season, we have a Republican candidate that has gathered enough delegates to become the nominee, and we have a Democrat that's done the same. The first thing we have to understand is the way that this is going to come up in an exam. Exams usually will ask you something like assess the significance of National Party conventions or to what extent are National Party conventions important. And what that's getting at is, what are the traditional functions of a national party convention? And then, are national party conventions still used for that? And if not, what's the point of them? So, what I would do first of all is have a look at this video in Storify on the external link. I'm not going to play it for you right now, but watch that video to set it up. Now, when you've watched that video, okay, you'll get an understanding that the conventions are the official moment when you nominate the candidates. So even though we've been having primaries through all the preceding months and we already know who the candidate is, the national convention is the official moment when all of the party activists from the states, called delegates, they all gather together at the convention and formally cast their nomination for the presidency. So the traditional function was that they would in fact choose the candidate at the convention. Because America is such a big country, all of the delegates from the different states would never meet or communicate before the convention. So once every 4 years, they'd all get together and they'd actually pick the candidate. So traditional functions, as we can see, it's to pick the candidates. But as we know, this function now has been superseded by primaries. And then the second function was to actually debate and decide the platform. Okay. Now, the last time that happened was in 1996, where there was a big debate in the Republican convention on abortion. Now, that made, I mean, in 1996, the Republican candidate was Bob Dole. Now, he was running against Clinton, and Clinton was looking for his second term. And a massive argument about abortion on the floor of the convention does not present the image that you want. And so, all it did was make the party look divided. And so, in terms of the two traditional functions, deciding the platform, choosing the candidate, we can see that they don't do what they were supposed to do. So the question is, well, what are they for then? Well, modern functions. They're a chance for the entire party to meet together, and get together and decide between themselves what the key issues are. They don't debate. They don't you debate the actual platform, but it is a chance for all the delegates from the different states who never meet to get together. And this can identify future stars of the party. Arguably, if you watch this, Obama's speech to the convention in 2004 was the moment where he was then identified as a future presidential star. Now, as you can see here, in the 2012 election, GOP stars, rising stars, Chris Christie, Marco Rubio to address the RNC. Again, we'll just have a quick look at this video. Okay, we'll wait for the ad to finish. So, Chris Christie, New Jersey's brash and brassy Republican governor, will be unofficially crowned the party's rising star when he delivers a keynote address at the Republican National Convention later on. As you can see there, Christie has since run into some trouble, but at the time, he was an identified rising star. Another key person, Marco Rubio.
Chris Christie may not be running for president or vice president, but he will be taking center stage at this year's Republican National Convention. Christie has been tapped to give the keynote speech at the convention in Tampa, Florida later this month. It's the highest profile speaking slot at the convention. Governor Christie says he plans on raising some very direct and hard truths about the trouble our nation is in.
So as you can see there, Chris Christie in 2012 and Obama in 2004, keynote speeches that perhaps were a chance to identify future rising stars of the party. Chris Christie has since had a few issues since then, but still. In terms of uniting the party, you need to watch this video. Hillary Clinton suspended the roll call vote. You need to understand that they've just had a really bruising primary season, and the party convention is a chance to get those two candidates back together. In this video, if you watch it, Clinton, who had a really tough season against Obama for the nomination, effectively throws all of her weight behind Obama to help heal the party. It'll be interesting to see if Donald Trump does that, if he doesn't win, because that could be damaging for the Republicans. If Trump either wins and then the other candidates don't support him, or if another candidate wins and Trump doesn't support him or runs as an independent, the party convention is a chance to unite the party. Again, the keynote speeches are vital. These are really good videos to watch. Watching the 2012 speeches and then comparing them with the Republican ones, you can see that it's a really good chance to launch your campaign. Because all of the media spotlight is on the convention, this is the main reason for the convention now. It's a chance to launch the platform. Now, this isn't always a good thing. Now, if you watch this is great, because Clint Eastwood was the 2012 speaker. Again, if you have a look at the analysis from Politico, Eastwood's rambling RNC speech, Clint Eastwood delivered a rambling performance. Just pause that and just have a quick read of the main bits. Compare that. You've got that going in week one, and then the week after when the Democrats went, you just contrast, if you've watched that, contrast it with the likes of this.
Mr. Mayor, fellow Democrats, we are here to nominate a president.
Now, having a Hollywood actor who wasn't very clear, wasn't very coherent, against former President Bill Clinton, who delivers a very rousing, very clear and well-structured speech, the Democrats in 2012 had a clear advantage coming out of the convention. The location is significant, as you can see here. The Republican Party chose Florida. Now, why would they choose Florida? Well, this paragraph gives the reason. Key swing states are generally chosen to host the convention because they carry those vital electoral college votes that are going to decide the election. So Florida, with its 27, the Democrats that year held theirs in North Carolina, another swing state, a key swing state with a good chunk, 15 electoral college votes. So you can see there that that can be a significance. And effectively, what we can finally say is that the final keynote of the presidential candidates can be so significant that many voters will be swung by that speech. Now, in 2008, Sarah Palin delivered a very, very good speech at the Republican convention. And following the convention, Republicans were in front. And then this moment happened. In fact, this is so good it needs to be full screen. This is the image that we have to focus our minds on. I mean, Obama did deliver a great keynote, but look at that picture. That just speaks volumes, doesn't it, about the Democrat convention and the rousing music. It was just that moment, really, was unassailable for the impact that it had. So again, that really launched Obama into the campaign. Now, it wasn't the final factor. There were lots of ups and downs in the rest of the campaign, but you can see here that the party convention can't be ignored. Now, you might notice, and apologies for this, that the analysis is slightly Democrat biased, but that's probably because in the most recent two examples that we have, 2008 and 2012, the Democrats won. So I think that should give you the main points. And at the bottom here, I've written an example 15 marker, so you can also have a look at that. Okay, so hopefully that clears things up. We will discuss that in the lesson.